Well, there's a look from our Baraboo Skycam, currently 6:09, and right now it's 62 degrees here on the west side of town. Well, Girl Scouts have their cookies, but Boy Scouts have popcorn. And here to tell us more about the popcorn sale is Les German of the Glacier Edge Council, and he is joined by Aaron Vickmeyer. Is that how you say it? Close enough?
Close enough. Vickmeyer.
Vickmeyer. Well, morning to both of you.
Good morning.
And Les, let's start with you talking about the popcorn sale. What do you have?
Well, our popcorn sale usually starts every September. Last year, we were able to sell $1,240,000 in retail sales,
wow,
which is number five within the council size of our location. This year, we'll be selling again in September. We have seven different types of products. Boys normally go door to door, or they do a show and sell program with the leaders where they go in front of stores such as Walmart, Target, mm-hmm, etc., and they're able to participate in the sale. And 70% of the local, 70% of the dollars that are raised as far as from the sale actually go back to the scouting program in itself.
So the popcorn is already popped or it's unpopped?
The popcorn is already popped. We have seven different types. We have butter light, butter, caramel light. Some cheese popcorn as well, too. And one of the good things, too, is that some people may want to support our military, that they can either purchase a $25 item or a $40 item that gets shipped directly overseas to the military while they're in the other countries right now.
Oh, that's neat. Now, all of the money that's raised stays right here locally?
Stays locally, yes.
And what is some of that money going for, Aaron?
Well, we use a lot of that to help support our summer camps and our other programs we do throughout the year, like working with underprivileged youth in the Scout Reach program. So we've got a lot of opportunities for kids to get involved in scouting, and we try to make sure they have the advantages to utilize our facilities. We have two camps that we maintain with summer camp experiences for the boys to go have a lot of fun with. There's still opportunities for the boys to go if they're looking for, you know, ways to get out this summer. We can still sign them up if they go to our website, and parents can click on the parents link and then how to join scouting, and we'll be able to find them a pack or a troop for the different ages of the boys to get them involved with some summer camp experiences.
And tell us the age range that you deal with.
They start at first grade and go through fifth grade, or 7 to 10, and that's our Cub Scout program. Then we have the Boy Scout program, which is the 11 to 18 years old. And then we have the Venturing program and Exploring program, which are our co-ed programs, 14 to 20 years of age, where the Venturing program is more of the high adventure outdoor activities. The Exploring program is almost like a career exploration where we work with a lot of law enforcement agencies, EMS, fire departments, where they give the kids a chance to really see what it is to be in that role, work with officers or firefighters, and then after they turn 18 or 20, they can start looking at that as a career.
Boy, hard to believe it all starts with eating some popcorn.
Yep.
Amazing what that can all turn out to be. Now, you also have another big event that I get to be a part of, Les, coming up on the 25th.
We do. It's a Distinguished Citizens Breakfast, which will be held at the Concourse Hotel. It starts at 7 o'clock in the morning. We're honoring John Wall, which is Terrence's son.
Father.
And we're also, Craig Culver from Culver's Franchising Systems is the keynote speaker. So if people are interested in helping supporting scouting in another way, they can go to www.glaciersedge.org.
And, you know, I can't say, although I was not a Boy Scout, I was a Girl Scout. I can't say enough about the experience. My husband still talks about going to Boy Scout camp when he was younger. In fact, do they still have Canyon Camp?
Canyon Camp?
Canyon Camp. It's in northern Illinois. That's where he went.
I think it's still there in northern Illinois.
He still remembers all of that, too. So a memorable experience for young boys. And hopefully you can all support it by buying a little popcorn.
Appreciate it.
Enjoying it. Well, thanks so much, gentlemen. And Sarah Jessica Parker and her gal pals leave the city for their new flick. Coming up on Weekend Live, the movie's hitting the theaters this weekend. Plus, I'm going to take a look at your Weather Authority forecast. Right now, temperatures are very pleasant in the upper 50s. We'll be right back.
While you're connecting with friends, you can follow us on Facebook. We'll bring you breaking news, severe weather, and more.